I am a recovering statistician, and that means that you can never take the grumpy out. No matter how cheerful I am, there's always that little element of grumpy. So I'm a statistician by training, and I've always found data to be beautiful. Statistics was my easy A in college when I went at 50 and didn't know what I was doing. I was like, which thing is going to be my easy A? Statistics, apparently. But what I do believe is while data are pretty, it is decisions that are important. It's through our actions, through our decisions that we affect the world. So what better thing to study than that? Except there's no major like that. So there I'm going through taking full majors in the stuff, psychology, neuroscience, economics at the University of Chicago, those who like Chicago, statistics, machine learning, analytics, to get at what I believe is the best possible thing anyone could know about, which is how to turn information into better action in any setting, at any scale. So that is what my life's passion has been about. As part of all this other crazy stuff that I'll do, product startup, etc., I also really hope to maybe co-found an academic institute that focuses on decision making as the core thing that is taught, rather than going with academic disciplines and, you know, taking all the other stuff, looking for that little nugget, taking a whole rest of the major along with. I want a ruthless focus on good decision making, and modern good decision making must involve data. You have to, if you want to call yourself a true expert in decision making, it has to be information at any scale, in any setting. You have to know when not to use information. You have to know, let's say you want to make many decisions, you're automating your will, essentially. That's AI. How do you do that safely, reliably, effectively? How do you do that if you have a big team? How do you coordinate people? How do you think about incorporating new technological advances into your decision making? So that is broadly what I'm passionate about. I have been advising since I was but a wee egg, starting in college and now through to now. And I've been at Google for almost 10 years, where, yes, I was first a chief data scientist in our office of the CTO. So I had a good office of the CTO stint, and now I am chief decision scientist. It's fascinating. If you look at job titles, say circa 2016-17, there's no decision science, there's no decision intelligence. And now I feel, look, I don't presume to know what it must be like to be a man who accidentally has many children that they have never kept track of. he just is like, what? I have this child and I have that child. But I'm finding all these startups that are decision intelligence startups, and I'm like, hey, I pioneered that. I remember sitting in 2016 figuring out what should we call this discipline. There was one other startup that was a consulting startup that was using the term. I was like, that's fine. We'll call it decision intelligence engineering and hope everyone forgets the engineering, because DIE is a terrible acronym, you know, an acronym that must die. But now it's become popular because people realize after all these failures that chasing the shiny toy isn't working. Chasing the essential is what does work. So what decision intelligence stands for is the combination of what's traditionally thought of as the decision sciences, which haven't actually had that data component. In the 70s, you could be studying the decision sciences. That would be the economic psychology, you know, the social managerial sciences. You could do that and you never had to know any statistics, you let alone AI, machine learning, etc. And I feel like that discipline is impotent in the modern world without the muscle of being able to really keep going no matter what the scale is, no matter what the setting is. And the data sciences likewise are impotent without the decision sciences. For what and why? What's the point of the problem? And it's so fascinating to see that people who get the degrees in data science are almost reinforced to not think about the business. I mean, imagine if you're going to graduate from your statistics PhD, the number of times that you would have had to answer some inane question about, you know, Sally has this many rabbits in a field, and how many rabbits does Sally have 5 years later? So completely inane. You are disincentivized, though, from saying, why should I even tackle this? No, you're going to sit and do the most complicated mathematics you know how. And when you're then released, foisted upon the world, like, what do you know about business? What do you know about decisions? What do you know about being useful? That's not the skill. So we really need to jam these two disciplines together, take the best of both of them. What is decision scientist? It's more like I'm counterbalancing the data science side. I am cheerleading that the decision sciences are necessary, Also because otherwise I'd have to be a chief decision intelligence whatnot. chief decision intelligence engineer, which brings us back to the terrible acronym, so we're going to avoid that. But yeah, there is that confusion of the decision sciences being having some traditional baggage and me trying to cheerlead them back. What I find in decision scientists who take their work seriously, whether they've got the data piece or not, is it's a weird personality thing you have to do, because you have to genuinely not care about the options presented to you. And that is strange. Like, usually someone says, okay, help me with A or B. And you would know, you would advise, because you believe in A, and you kind of convince the person to go with A because you like that as well. Whereas a true decision scientist has to be like, no, it's not about A or B. It's about serving the decision. I want to make sure that you make the best possible decision for you, not for me, not my opinion. I need to make sure that you fully understand everything you have to understand. I'm going to give you the bigger brain, but you still choose between A and B. And that's pretty hard to do. There is so much BS, pardon my Shakespeare, out there about AI. And I have this course called Making Friends with Machine Learning. It's recorded in a classroom setting. And it was designed, it was actually a challenge. I should have laughed in the person's face who said, told me to do this. But instead I was like, I like a challenge. So they said, can I make a machine learning course that is suitable for the following? A CEO, a researcher in AI, and a high schooler with no math background. And I should have laughed, but I was like, no, I'm gonna do it. So those are the three target audiences for this course. And so it's all analogy based, but it's correct, because when you understand the technology, you get the analogies right. Helps people think through the stuff. So when you, if you find poor victims of the hype who are just saying words at you and they have no idea what they're saying, and it would be helpful to give them a little education, that's a course that's good for that. This is a deep question. We haven't, you know. Oh no! Okay, I'll bare my soul. Fine. What success looks like for me. What I'm an ambassador of is better decision making. Better decision making the modern way. Improving individual skills for individuals across the board, but more importantly, more than ever before these days, you have decision makers who have that kind of outsized influence that only kings and popes could have had hundreds of years ago. And now almost anybody could build something, do something, create a piece of technology. It impacts millions, billions of lives. And if that person doesn't have the skills to be thoughtful through the process of thinking through what they're doing, why they're doing it, why the world should have it, the world does not end up better off. I would like the world to be better off rather than worse off. So it's like, if we're all stumbling around at 5 kilometers, 5 miles an hour, what's the harm we could do? Let's walk drunk, it's fine. The minute somebody has a car in a crowded area, then I want to know who's got skills. And I feel that very strongly about the modern world. So whatever I can do to make leaders a little better, I want to do that. So that's what I'm an ambassador and evangelist of. As for what success looks like for me, when I die, I want to know that the world was a bit better at making decisions because of me. I've actually kind of reached that goal by having made Google a lot better. Google's a big organization. That change has good echoes in the world. So I actually feel like, all right, I'm done. I can, you know, just sort of rest on my laurels and binge Netflix for the rest of my life. However, I am unstoppable. So continuing to improve decision making and put on a damn good show while I do it, because I'm a thespian at heart. I do love the performing arts. That's my other identity when I'm not being about data and decisions. I'm in the theater, I'm consuming, then I go and act as myself. So I love that. And so knowing that I made people better at decision making, and knowing that I managed to speak on really cool stages, leave people inspired, delighted, that's success. And I do have that super secret stealthy, it is around decision making, product idea, and making that a reality would be pretty good success too.